There's still a lot of snow in Whitehorse. It's melting and soft, so we wear our snowshoes on our trek in hope to see the northern lights in the open sky. It's only 10:30 at night, but the aurora forecast is strong, so we head out earlier than usual for aurora viewing. It's April 17th, it's spring, and it's above zero, I don't even have gloves on, and we can still see the northern lights at this time of the year.
Wow, look at that. It's crazy.
You, Tenshi? What do you think of these aurora? You never really seem to be looking up at them. Not interested? Great thing about the aurora, Tenshi, is they're always different. Every time it's a different show. Come by the fire? Huh? Come by the fire? Hi. Hi. Hi there. How you doing? How you doing, Tenshi? How are you doing, Tenshi? Pretty soon we won't be able to see northern lights.
No, it'd be too light out, eh?
Yeah.
This might be one of the last one.
Yeah.
In the season.
Well, I've seen them as late as the beginning of May.
Yeah.
It's super rare though.
Yeah. In terms of the tour, most tour companies finish the season in the middle of April, mm-hmm. which is right now. Mm-hmm. But I've seen northern lights in May too, like probably May 9th, May 13th even.
But that's unusual.
That's very unusual, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, soon there will be midnight sun and people will be having barbecues.
Yeah.
At midnight.
Yeah. It's amazing how fast the snow is melting right now.
Yeah.
It was like plus 14 during the day today.
It was plus 14?
It was plus 14. Yeah. 1 week before this, it was minus 24 in the morning.
Yeah, it was.
So
minus 25. Don't take away that 1 degree.
Okay, so from minus 25 to
yeah.
plus 14.
Yep, do the math.
That's like a 30 degrees difference in 1 week.
Yeah.
You know, how can you handle that?
Yeah.
And then the first songbird that comes back is usually a dark-eyed junco.
Yeah, and they're back.
And also ruby-clawed kinglet that goes chip-chip-cheek, chip-cheek, chip-cheek. And I heard that yesterday for the first time and I'm so happy.
Aww.
You know, it's like, oh, finally, you know, birds know when the spring is. And when they come back, they're like, okay, this is official.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
So officially, spring started yesterday, for me anyway.
Because of the ruby-crowned kinglet.
Yeah. It is.
What about the swans?
Swans are here a little earlier.
Yeah, that's true.
So you can never kind of tell, you know, the real sign of spring.
But the juncos just arrived yesterday.
Exactly. So those early songbirds come back when the snow is ready to be gone.
Spring and northern lights. Oh, and the boreal owl as well.
Yep.
It's another sign. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ooh, I'm getting cold because the fire is going down.
Yeah.
And we're going to go ice fishing tomorrow, so
yeah,
we might have to end this Aurora Borealis party.
Yeah.
This is such an early night to end though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Normally we're out here until 2, 3 in the morning, still trying to see the aurora, and it was a nice early show.
Yeah, well, it's coming back a little bit.
Oh, it is?
Behind us.
Oh my gosh, holy smokes. We're facing the wrong way, but the camera, the camera is checking out the lights behind us.
I set it up that way.
So yeah, of course.
We can see that.
But we can't see them.
That's okay. You can turn around. There we go. It's starting.
Woo! Another big show. Yeah. Dying down. The aurora is still out. It's after midnight and our dog is tired. She's decided to head home and I think we will too. This is our way of living simply and exploring the wild. So thanks so much for watching, and if you feel like it, please subscribe to our channel.